My dad bought the Ten Commandments and Lois Pratt illustrated on a nice frame. And I had looked at that picture of the Sixth Commandment, thou shalt not kill. There's a picture of how Cain had killed his brother Abel. Now, what in the world could a brother do such a thing? I've pictured Christ as saving life. I want to be like Christ, I was saving life instead of taking life. And that's the reason I take up the medicine.
Desmond Doss was drafted into the Army in April 1942. He wanted to serve his country, but electing not to bear arms, the Virginia native instead joined the Army Medical Corps. Assigned to the U.S. invasion of Okinawa, where deeply entrenched Japanese forces hammered American troops from caves and tunnels, Doss and his battalion were ordered to assault a jagged 400-foot escarpment overrun with Japanese defenders.
Japanese had been there for years. They had that mountain with honeycomb and camouflage to look like natural terrain. And that's what we had to face. So I remember 8 or 9 of those Japanese positions we destroyed before we contacted A Company. And when the day was done, I didn't have a single man killed. The next day, we thought the big job was done, but instead, everything we were trying this day went wrong. We threw hail, all types of high explosive demolition on the Japanese position. We decided it was only one thing left to do. We had 35 gallons of high-octane gasoline and 5-gallon Army water cans. 2 men cut a hose, opened the can, lit it up, threw it, literally threw it over the bank. The ammunition dump must have gone off. That whole mountain just seemed to quiver. You could take anything, it would be able to slide it. But to our surprise, out came these Japanese from both sides for us.
Showering Doss's battalion with artillery, mortar, and machine gun fire, the Japanese drove the majority of the group back down the face of the escarpment. But dozens of casualties were still left behind.
I had these men up there, and I shouldn't leave them. They were my buddies. Some of my men were families, and they trust me. I didn't feel like I should value my life above my buddies. So I decided to stay with them and take care of as many of them as I could. I didn't know how I was going to do it.
Doss remained to tend the wounded, dragging them to the cliff's edge and attempting to lower them down the escarpment.
But I didn't have enough rope to do the job like it should be done. Then the Lord brought to my mind that knot I learned in West Virginia I'd never seen or heard of before.
Relying on his childhood experience rescuing flood victims, Doss fashioned a special sling that enabled him to lower the men one by one to safety.
So I just kept praying, Lord, please help me get one more, until there was none left. And I was the last one down.
By nightfall, he had managed to rescue 75 fallen comrades.
There's 15 of us got the medal that day. When my time came, I went up. President Truman, he came up and he stepped over the line and caught me by my hand and shook my hand like an old-time friend, somebody he'd been knowing all his life. He didn't even give me a chance to get nervous. When you had explosives and bullets so close you could practically feel it, and not get wounded up there when I should have been killed a number of times. I know who I owe my life to as well as my men. That's why I like to tell this story to the glory of God, because I know from a human standpoint I should not be here. You can't always win, but when your buddies come to you and say, they owe their life to me, What better reward can you get than that?